8 years old, he had lost 5 siblings. At 9, he was left for dead, only to awaken from a coma paralyzed. But he recovered from a seemingly hopeless state of body and mind. Bradley Quick is here to share with you his path from Skid Row junkie to successful talk show host, author, mentor, and motivational speaker. If you're looking for a better tomorrow, if you want a positive evolution, or if you're in need of a quick fix, you're in the right place. Now kick back and get ready for the top experts in the field of body, mind, and soul. Here on The Quick Fix with Bradley Quick. Purpose, power, motivation.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to The Quick Fix on Cool Change Radio, your home for positive answers and the place to find that life and health solution you've been looking for. Today's show is brought to you by the Cool Change Foundation. If you're fond of this show, if it's brought you some breakthrough solutions, or you just want to help this show stay on the air, please donate today. You see, when we make life better for mom and dad, we make life better for the children. When we make life better for the children, we make life better for the family. Everybody wins. The Cool Change Foundation provides transformative content and techniques and strategies to parents to help them release negative habits. It's 100% tax-deductible donation. No donation is ever too small. You can donate now at thecoolchangefoundation.org. That's thecoolchangefoundation.org. Remember, it's time for a cool change with the Cool Change Foundation. Welcome, everyone. My guest today is Kyle Cease, comedian, author, actor, and acclaimed speaker. He's currently one of the most in-demand young comics, selling out over 200 shows last year from coast to coast. And he is just right here on the camera. Say hello, Kyle.
Hi, everybody. How
Hi,
are
everybody.
You? So I'm happy to be here.
I am honored to have you here, Kyle. Thank you.
Thank you for having me here.
Dude, it's such an honor, man.
Thank
Truly.
You. It's an honor for me.
So hold tight
Thank
just
you for
a second.
Having me.
I'm going to have you on the show. I'm going to ask the tough questions.
Thank
I promise
you.
The people that that's going to be
you very
had.
Much.
So here we go.
But thank you for having me. Wouldn't that be weird if that was the show? Just us thanking each other for an hour? That'd be weird.
It's pretty much what it's going to be, you know?
But what would be weirder would be three munchkins coming in here same time, and they were like, what's up? I'm Oprah. And you're like, you're three people, you know? So there's
Oprah's
weird
three,
things that can
Oprah
happen.
That Oprah would be three munchkins.
Absolutely.
That would be pretty weird.
Yeah, so I'm just saying we can up it weirder.
We can really up the weird quotient.
Right now, with that joke, the viewers went up or down really fast. like two people dropped off. Like, I don't know what that was. I'm not going to grow if he's going to talk about unicorns, which I didn't talk about
until right now.
So yeah. Just, so now I was speaking for the future. I live in where I want it to be. And so they're going to say that.
And what's really weird too is that people can actually call in. They can actually phone and dial.
Excellent.
They can call in.
Awesome.
If you want to chime in with a question, you know, like what does that mean that Oprah is three
sure.
munchkins?
Right. Well, I'm just saying that all I was saying was when I realized that would be weird if we did
right.
say thank you the whole time.
Right.
I just thought it'd be kind of cool to talk about what would be weirder because I realized it's not that weird compared to because everything's only based on comparison. So,
right.
you know, if three munchkins came in here for on a unicorn and they were like, what's up? I'm Oprah. You'd be like, you're three people. That'd be really I'm just saying that'd be weirder.
That would be weird. And you know, weird is really the new normal. So.
Absolutely.
So
that's my new MySpace slogan. I just got MySpace. I think it's going to do really well.
Yeah, and I hear that it's you know that it's Oprah's buying in. So.
I also got an Atari and a Van Damme movie.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Are you still wearing Converse?
Not anymore.
No,
that's 80s.
That's so. I'm sorry. I'm so unhip.
Yeah. No, well, I think you're great.
Thanks, man.
I'm
Thank
a big
you.
Fan.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you. Thanks for being a guest. I guess my first question: a lot of people want to know how's it going. You know,
it's. You know, I'm not sure. Sometimes I'm not really sure how it's going. It's
right.
going. It's clearly going. But like, how?
Yeah.
Man, it just goes.
Oh, yeah. That's probably resistance.
It feels like I'm sweating now. I'm noticing.
Yeah. Well, you're doing fine, Brian. My next guest is going to be... I'm just kidding. I don't have anyone. That'd be funny.
It'd be funny if it was like three munchkins
yeah.
who are Oprah.
Oh,
were
that would
next
be
guest.
So weird if that happened. So that's weird
right?
for a different reason if they actually showed up now.
That would be like, my next guest is
yeah.
Oprah and
Absolutely.
Three munchkins. So
I hear you, man.
If you want to call in and have a conversation and ask a question, clearly there's just no question too weird for this show today. Please
let's
pick up
call.
The phone and dial 818-824-9123. That's 818-824-9123. One more time.
828. Oh, wait.
Oh, no, he just changed it on me. It's
8-1. No, you said
8-2. I did. I know. I'm going to go with 8-1.
Okay.
Because I got two different, but I'm pretty sure it's going to be 818.
Let's do it in, you know, harmony? You're musical, right?
I'm totally musical,
yeah.
Man.
So,
you want to, let's do it in harmony. So,
okay.
I'll go 818. Where are you going to be? 818-824-9123. That was totally unrehearsed, in case anyone thinks that that was tight.
Yeah, wouldn't that be weird?
The engineer's clapping.
They clearly rehearsed that for a month. It would be so solid.
That would be, if we rehearsed that for a month and that's what we came up with, I mean...
What was the number again?
818-824-9123.
Okay, let's do it in the notes of California Girls by the Beach Boys. So you go, 818-823.
It's 2-4.
Yeah, never mind, because the...
I can't even... 818-824-9123.
818-824-9123.
818. I just changed the key on you.
Yeah. Because the... I wish that... That's the key it's in.
818-824-9123.
That was pretty cool.
That was better.
Yeah, it's getting better.
I enjoyed this.
See,
what if our whole interview was just us rehearsing?
I know. And then no one calls or anything. It's just us like singing for an hour about the number.
So look, Kyle, man, I met you through the Global Alliance for Transformational Entertainment, and honestly, one of my you know, I love comedy, and I met you as a comedian.
We actually also met at Agape, very quickly.
That's actually a correct statement.
That was
the
first place
for at Agape.
Mm-hmm.
That's right, because we performed, the band that I managed, yeah. Here to Here, we performed.
It was awesome.
It was awesome. And then I saw you also, although I think that was after our meeting, that the clip that you did when you did the announcements that day.
Yeah.
Right? And you had Michael Beckwith, you had the poster board. Dude, you're brilliant, man.
Thank
you. You're absolutely brilliant.
Thank you very much.
You know, in fact, you have on your YouTube page, which is youtube.com/KyleCease.
Please follow me there. Yeah.
Right?
There's all kinds of stuff.
You,
there.
Like the main video right now is one that's Life is Beautiful.
Life is a playground.
Life is a playground.
Yeah.
Thank you. Life is a playground.
Yeah. It's not beautiful.
It's pretty.
Nah. It's
but it is a playground.
A really messy playground,
it's
actually.
It's a pretty messy playground.
Yeah. No, it's, yeah. But what were you going to say about that video?
Well, you know, you had a clip from that Agape announcement that you did, you know, making light of and of the law of attraction and all that stuff. And, you know, that's one of the things that I had not seen. Obviously, you know, comedy is I think the prevailing wisdom is it's funny because it's truthful,
mm-hmm.
right?
Yeah, I think that it's weird for me because I'm a comedian. I've been a comedian for 20 years, and then I started, you know, I hit a low, and then I suddenly kind of saw the entire matrix that we live in and understand it completely by doing a lot of work on myself and everything. And I found that overall, not everybody, but overall, what comics' strength is a lot of times is they're extremely authentic. They're about the truth, right? Mm. And not all of them, but I mean most of them are about what's real. So they're very good at finding, you know, the crap in things. You mm-hmm. know what I mean by
mm-hmm.
that?
Mm-hmm.
And so, but then here's the other thing is that a lot of them aren't very positive, you know? Mm-hmm. And I don't mean it knocking it. I actually really love a lot of comics, but the realistic side, when they say I'm just being realistic, it can be very dark and very scary. Mm-hmm. And so I kind of entered the self-help world because I really was searching for that positive truth, but I find a lot of them aren't authentic.
Yeah.
And what I mean by that is there are some definitely, and there are the we know who they are and they're amazing, you know, that are incredible, but there's a lot of times this thing where sometimes people change the outside but not the in, they change the show, you know, where, you know, I just think sometimes we need a balance between a lazy guy in Dayton, Ohio, that doesn't believe anything is possible. But then people who change their name to Rainbow Maca Sunshine and don't shave their armpits. Like, there's got to be a middle, because you know what I mean by those people that are just the long starers that want you to know they've changed, but they don't do the real work.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
And they just stare at you for 10 minutes now. Like when they're listening to you, they want you to. They're like, mm.
Well, a friend of mine calls that Hallmark spirituality.
Mm-hmm.
You know, where it's just kind of in the sort of namby-pamby, beautiful. Oh, everything is sunshine realm, and really ignores the, there's, like you say, that sort of the it's not even a middle ground. It's just an embracing of the totality of life.
Right. It becomes a thing to hold on to and a story. And I find that it's hysterical sometimes if I go to an event and I'm funny there and they're like, no, we are very serious. Mm-hmm. We're trying to get happy. And I'm like, I'm making jokes. We're laughing right away. And they're like, yeah, no, we have a 7-day process of letting go. And how it works is we have everybody bring up everything that's ever happened in their past and they refeel it. And then they leave the event going, I figured out who I am. I'm this person that's over that girl cheated on me. And then they say that for a year.
Yeah.
And if you're saying that for a year, not over it. And so I find that it's hysterical that we're talking about being this way. And like, we forget that we're being spiritual when we're laughing. We're being connected when we're laughing. You're in the moment being happy. And I've found that there needs to be a bridge. I think that the reason a lot of people don't jump into self-help is because there isn't a bridge there that's safe to them. There isn't a being real. It's such a far jump. And there also can be just laughing and being real and talking about things is okay too. Mm-hmm. And just being in the moment. I mean, laughter is the fastest way into the zone. You know, the ego has this thing in it that it takes 90 days to get somewhere. You know, I'm going to, like, when you hear people say, I'm going to meditate for 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. Well, you just put yourself in the future when you said that.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you're trying to get into the zone. Okay, well, there is no zone to get into. You are the zone, and you need to be there, and you are there instantly. You don't sit there and decide there has to be this process. I'm not saying I'm against the process, but only the ego is this thing that decides, I needed to achieve a 21-day thing into getting into the zone.
Mm-hmm.
Because if you want to, you're there right now. You're there. And the part of you that's checking is still ego, and that's conditioning that will leave if you just decide to love that, play with it, and love that it's there. Do you know what I'm saying?
Absolutely, man. Look, we're going to get ready to go into a quick commercial here. It's just flying by, and but I want to explore this more about, bringing the levity to life, to spirituality as well, because I think that's such a timely message.
Yes.
So thank you for being here.
Thank
man.
You, man.
It's such an honor to have you here, Kyle. And
I'm honored to be here,
we'll
man.
We'll be right back with Kyle Cease. Stay put. Have you got a habit that you want to change? How would you do things different to better your life experience? Well, we just might have some insight for you, so stay put. I am here with Kyle Cease, comedian, author, actor, and acclaimed speaker. This is The Quick Fix on Cool Change Radio. We're broadcasting live from Freddie Siegel Studios. My name is Brian Reeves. I am sitting in for Bradley Quick this week. We'll be right back. Thank you all for joining us. Thank you.
Today, experience The Quick Fix, a simple process for positive change, written by Bradley Quick, author, producer, motivational speaker, and host of the award-winning radio talk show, The Quick Fix with Bradley Quick on CoolChangeRadio.com. Bradley's passion for life is evident in his book, written so you can experience health, find your purpose, and have more effective relationships. Beating insurmountable odds, overcoming death and being paralyzed, Bradley fought his way back so he could help you conquer your struggles. Experience increased health, vitality, passion, and purpose in your life right now with The Quick Fix, and read about Bradley's courage, ambition, and determination to live. Whether the issue is your thoughts, your physical body, or you just want to feel better and be happy, The Quick Fix, a simple process for positive change, will change your life. For only $19.95 plus shipping and handling, take positive action now and receive a free guided meditation CD with your order. That's a $20 value free with your order today. Go to BradleyQuick.com. That's BradleyQuick.com. Take control and begin feeling better now. Get the book and free CD now at BradleyQuick.com.
You're listening to The Quick Fix with Bradley Quick. Purpose, power, motivation. We'll be right back.
This has never been attempted before by any treatment center, ever. Seasons Malibu is willing to take the risk because they understand quality care and evidence-based long-term recovery. Pay for only 3 months of treatment and stay until you are better, period. I'll say that one more time. Pay for only 3 months of treatment and stay until you are better. Enough is enough. Seasons Malibu wants to count your days of recovery, not the dollars in your pocket. No gimmicks, no guarantees, just straightforward world-class treatment until you are better. Do not hesitate. Call now. Seasons Malibu, 866-780-8539, 866-780-8539. That's Seasons Malibu at www.seasonsmalibu.com or 866-780-8539, 866-780-8539. For a free consultation and details, 866-780-8539.
Welcome back. You are listening to The Quick Fix on Cool Change Radio, your home for self-improvement and a place for positive change. I am Brian Reeves, and we are here right now to help you gain the upper hand in becoming all that you want to be. This segment is brought to you by the guys from GapZip.com. They ask, how do you think? They say, how you think is more important than what you think. It's one of the chief reasons why many of you get stuck when you try to take a next step in your career and personal relationships. You can join the two dynamic guys from GapZip.com who actually teach people how to think. Join them live every second and fourth Tuesday evening at 7 Pacific. Sign up with them so you too can learn a new way to think. Go to GapZip.com. That's GapZip.com. For those of you just joining us on Cool Change Radio, Facebook, or BradleyQuick.com, welcome. You can listen to this show again or to hundreds of hours of other self-discovery content anytime you want by simply going to BradleyQuick.com. You can also join his email list, and there's also, he has podcasts. Listen anytime, anywhere at BradleyQuick.com. My guest today, let me pull him up on screen because y'all want to see him. He's a beautiful man, is Kyle Cease, comedian, author, actor, and acclaimed speaker. His Comedy Central one-hour special, Kyle Cease, Weirder, Blacker, Dimpler, premiered in 2007 to astronomically high, beautifully high, wonderfully high ratings. His half-hour special, Comedy Central Presents Kyle Cease, was the most played half-hour special on Comedy Central in 2006. And, you know, I am just so fascinated by Kyle Cease because he's bringing, you know, he's bringing levity to what's traditionally been a pretty heavy conversation, at least kind of in our Western, you know, approaches to it, this belief that our spiritual practice or religion, whatever it is, has to have a serious heaviness to it. And I love that your videos, they go places, you know, I'm that kind of person too. And it takes courage to walk on that edge of, you know, going the off limits comedy. You know, or the things that's true. Oh, you can't make fun of that, or you can't talk about that.
Right.
Or,
I mean, that's why it's funny because, you know, when you look at a baby coming out, it's born and it's totally content and it's happy, and you can do anything with it. A baby can just stare at a wall for 4 days. It's like, look at white, everybody. Did you guys see this? And like everybody loves the baby. You can do anything with the baby. You could go into a war zone with the baby and be like, baby here, and everyone would stop what they're doing. And by the way, if you have it, you want to present it like this.
That's how you hold a baby in a war zone, or just in general?
Well, if you go anywhere with your hand like this, it's good news. You know what I mean?
Okay.
Like, because it's always hors d'oeuvres or something. Like, there's no one that's ever robbed a bank with like this. You know, it's always, if you see a guy whose elbow's up, you know good news is coming. But my point is that in the moment place, it's so funny to me, is the same place where we all want to go. Because if you ask anybody what they want, they will tell you, oh, I can just see myself living on the beach or just in a cabin in the woods writing on paper, just really simple. Do you know we can do that now? Like, it's hysterical to me why we think we need this weird middle achiever place in, well, I got to make money. No, the cabin place is way cheaper. In fact, it costs nothing what your dream is. Mm-hmm. You know, it's bizarre to me. We go into the forest, we cut down trees, we make houses with them, and we get tired of the houses, so we go camping in the forest. Like, I feel like there's a middle ground we just don't need to do. Mm-hmm. And if you go to that place, that's the goal to be, is just no rules. Mm-hmm. You know, to have all these rules combined in there is not, it's like truly, in my opinion, being spiritual is having no resistance to anything. It's having no resistance to, and because when you say I'm spiritual, but you have all these rules, it has to be this way, this way, this way, you're just deciding that's what spiritual means.
So, but just making a new religion.
Right. Yeah. And If you can just be and allow, you know, that's actually the thing I think that makes people actually dying to have that growth. If you look at who the comics were that were the greatest, we say George Carlin or Bill Hicks, right? Mm-hmm. Those are comics that were swearing, they were doing all kinds of stuff, but you know what they did was they were telling the truth. Now, why is there everyone in the world, you know, why are 90% of the world against self-help, but they're for George Carlin? Because there's a 2-inch bridge that just needs to be closed. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yes.
Because George Carlin is making you aware, right? But then when you get to a place, you know, I did a seminar. I was speaking at a seminar. I was emceeing at a seminar. And I went backstage. And the whole seminar was about basically how to make money. It had a spiritual tone to it. But its belief was, you know, you need money to be happy. Now, my belief is when you're happy, you'll make money. And that will be a byproduct of it. You know what I'm saying? Like, mm-hmm. who cares? You'll make the money.
Mm-hmm.
But your goal is to be in the zone. And when mm-hmm. you're in the zone, your creativity's through the roof. The money skyrockets. Your bank account skyrockets. But you're not doing it for that. But if you say, when I make money, I'll be happy, you will be a slave to money. You will be you will put yourself, if you say anything outside of me will make me happy, you create a situation where you say to yourself, right. I'm in lack
whether
as is.
Whether it's a man, a woman, money, a job,
right.
a circumstance.
And right. everyone's under that illusion. Like if you're feeling fulfilled and you feel good and then a beautiful girl walks in front of you, suddenly you can't talk. Right? Why is that? Because you suddenly said that person completes me. Because mm-hmm. society has movies saying you complete mm-hmm. me in mm-hmm. songs, and you get under this illusion that you need someone to be happy. So it's funny though, because there's teachers that kind of teach that, some of them. But then I watch. I was backstage. I'm seeing an event once about 9 months ago, maybe, and I wanted to talk to this person. And this person's assistant goes, "Don't talk to that person right now, because we're putting together a subliminal pitch for the audience to sell something." And then the next day I wanted to talk to that person, and they said, in the next 6 hours, wow. don't say anything funny, because we
wow.
build tension
wow.
to sell stuff.
Wow.
We build tension. In other words, we scare the audience to buy
wow.
our stuff.
Wow.
And there was a thing in me that hurt so much, because when I wouldn't say I left the comedy scene, but when I moved from comedy over here primarily, I was so excited to be away from that negativity. And I thought, over here, it's going to be authentic positivity. But it's 50% authentic positivity. Like, I think you are. I think Gate
yeah.
is.
Yeah.
I think Agape is.
Yeah.
It's very authentic.
Yeah.
You know? But then there is this world where those people are saying, we have to make money to be happy, no matter what it takes. No matter how much... We aren't going to make the audience under the truth that they're free. We're going to get them under the illusion they need us.
Right.
And that's why I'm going, man, get real, get authentic, get in your place. And then you can actually sell more stuff, but you don't tell the audience they need it. You know,
right.
you offer it and people will go to it when they want it. But that's what scares everyone away.
Yeah.
That's the thing that scares. That's the thing that's missing in self-help.
Yeah.
Is that there is a truth that we are trying to share, but there then the half the people have tactics that scare people away.
Yeah.
And this
yeah.
is what's so important. And this bridge could make it enormous. Once that awareness is out, I think it'll make that stuff fall and the real truth grow. Because this is about the truth, not one person's success, right? If I'm out there going, I want to be the number one self-help guy, then I'm completely not living what I'm teaching.
Mm-hmm.
Do you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
The goal is to be in that zone and to be in that place and let the audience know that they are capable of their own breakthroughs and their own awareness and their own thing. And I had a seminar recently where I was teaching people, and the seminar was almost to get people unaddicted to seminars. And every time uh-huh. someone would have a breakthrough, uh-huh. I would say, okay, now just so you know, you did this,
uh-huh,
you know,
right.
you did this. Don't start associating it to me.
Right.
Because when people have a breakthrough, it doesn't matter what's around them. It could be a coffee pot and they'll be like, I'm addicted to coffee for
right,
life.
Right.
You know? So I can talk forever about that.
I've watched yesterday. I spent a lot of time watching your different videos, and I was really amazed at how much just wisdom is pouring through you, and how you can talk for 30 minutes just going, and it's, you know, your personality is infused in it with the humor, but the clarity that's coming through you is beautiful. And I've
Thank
worked
you.
With just spiritual teachers and artists and different people that are, you know, music, especially particularly in music. And I just see that channel flowing and I have to see it open. And one thing, you know, you spoke at the Awesomeness Festival,
yes,
the Awesomeness Gathering in Hawaii last year. And I watched the video of your presentation. And one thing that you said that I'd love for you to share with people about is living like unscripted.
Mm.
You know, how you, when you go to a friend's home, you don't go to a friend's home thinking, okay, I'm going to talk about this is what I'm, when I get there, I'm going to ask him this. I'm going to ask him about how's his dog. I'm going to ask him. Then they're going to move from that into, you know, that's not how
it's
life
hysterical.
Flows. Right?
I mean, why are we, when we, okay, so let's say you have a speech coming up or you're doing this radio show or someone has to do a presentation or a job interview, any of those things that we decide I have to plan it.
Yeah, can you imagine if I said, no, stop, I have another question for you. So, you know, tell me about your mother.
But you know what? There are shows that do that.
Really?
Yeah, I probably shouldn't say his name, but there's a late night talk show host that I don't feel has any communication going on.
Okay,
you know what I mean?
It's like, just the playing out the script. No, we're not going there. This is the question I have for you.
Yeah.
Let's answer that.
Like he'll interview someone and someone will say this whole thing and it'll open the door for such a great conversation. And then it'll be like, you got any pets? That voice gives you a hint. But I think that it's really weird that everything we do that is what we perceive to be high pressure, which is a total illusion.
Mm-hmm.
It's a total illusion that anything coming up is more important than this moment. Mm-hmm. Like if it's noon and I get a call that I'm on Comedy Central in a week, if I spend all day wondering how it's going to go, I waste noon, then I waste 12:01, then I waste 12:02, and I practice going into the future.
Mm-hmm.
I literally get good at worrying by putting my mind in the past and the future,
mm-hmm,
thinking of gigs that I screwed up on, thinking of that, and then linking it to this one, thinking, I hope it's not like this. And what happens is we actually get good at worrying. So, of course, when we go on the stage, we've mastered it.
Yeah.
You go on the stage in the past and future. So you bring this control part of you. I believe there's two us's. If you've ever given anybody advice and then learned from it, really, do you ever have that where you give someone advice and then you go, that's a good point, mate.
I'm only always speaking to myself.
Right.
I'm aware of that. Yes.
So who's the person talking and who's the person listening?
Yeah.
Now, this is where people get caught up. They argue about what the invisible thing is. They go, I think it's the universe. Well, I'm an atheist. I think it's your instinct. I think it's God. Okay, here's the thing. Just pick one and don't argue over it because you're missing the point.
Uh-huh.
You're spending moments not evolving because you're saying it's got to be the universe or Jesus or whatever,
uh-huh,
and you end up guarding a different invisible thing. I'm not saying any of those aren't true or are true, but just accept that there are two yous. Of course there are two yous. That's for sure. A part of you that worries and then a part of you that can answer the worrying.
Yeah.
So it's bizarre to me that whenever I'm about to do anything that's seemingly hugely important, including my Comedy Central hour, I do nothing but play all day. I don't give any more power to the show.
Mm-hmm.
And because of that, I didn't worry all day. When I go up, I don't have a guard up. And because of that, the creativity is bigger.
Mm-hmm.
And most of my work that's been huge has been full off-the-cuff stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Everything I've done. There's a video of me taking on 5 hecklers. It has 720,000 views.
Mm-hmm.
And it was just a moment of me playing because I have no rules. If
mm-hmm.
I had rules, if I said it has to be this joke, then this joke, then this joke, then when a heckler showed up, I would have been, this is out of my realm, and been worried.
You'd fall apart and you'd go right to just bounce or get them out.
Right. But that's what I really mean by life is a playground. Yeah. Like if you, everything, this is, I don't know how this is going to go. That's why it's real.
And let's come back to that. I'm totally breaking all the rules here.
Okay.
You know, and running the show, but you know what? That's how it goes sometimes.
Sure.
So we're going to go into a commercial here.
Awesome.
Man, Kyle, I'm so honored that you're here, brother. This is such a treat for me. So thank you. So we'll be right back. The music is going to start here in just a second, and we'll be right back with Kyle Cease. Music, keep in mind, we are here right now to inspire your life, to resolve issues in your career, health, and relationships, to empower you to be all that you can be. Because if you keep doing what you're doing, you're just going to keep getting what you're getting. This is Cool Change Radio, your home for self-improvement and a place to reshape your vision of what's possible. My name is Brian Reeves. I'm sitting in for Bradley Quick. My website is managingthemagic.com, managingthemagic.com, and we will be right back.
There are self-help seminars costing thousands of dollars guaranteeing miraculous transformations. There are compelling speakers and life-changing weekend experiences where you can walk on fire. They all deliver revelations that guarantee you'll come back for the more expensive revelations filled with even greater wonder next month on Fiji. We get addicted to positive, heartfelt, expensive theater. What we really need is a jumpstart, an awakening, someone who can give us a reminder that everything we need lies within. Through inspiration and practical knowledge, Dorothy Donahue helps people get grounded and motivated, inspired and energized. It's not just words and affirmations and the power of intention. It's a mindset brought about by a tangible, transcendental experience, an audio-visual, physical, spiritual experience that helps us realize we transform ourselves. We get tools to become the conscious co-creators of lives of unlimited potential. Find out more. Go to DorothyDonahue.com.
You're listening to The Quick Fix with Bradley Quick. Purpose, power, motivation. We'll be right back.
I'm Melody Beatty, author of Codependent No More. 7 times more Americans have hepatitis C than AIDS. I'm one of them. If you're one of the millions of Americans with hepatitis C and your doctors are treating you with interferon, then you're clearly aware of how your life has been turned horribly upside down. Backed by huge pharmaceutical monies, the medical community swears there's only one dangerous, disabling way to battle this silent killer. It's not true. There are alternatives, and they work. Triumph Over Hepatitis C is a book written by best-selling author Lloyd Wright, who fully recovered from this frightening disease. Lloyd is helping others to take charge of their lives and fight for their body's freedom from this crippling illness. His program is working for me. Call the people at Hepatitis C Free now at 866-HEP-C-FREE. That's 866-HEP-C-FREE. Don't become another medical statistic. Find out the truth about hepatitis C and get your life back.
Get your copy of Triumph Over Hepatitis C at Barnes & Noble and at HepatitisCFree.com. Call 866-HEP-C-FREE.
Welcome back. You are listening to Cool Change Radio, your home for self-improvement and a place to find your passion and purpose. My name is Brian Reeves. I'm sitting in for Bradley Quick. And right now, Bradley is in Teotihuacan, Mexico, home of the Toltec Pyramids. He asked me to host this show this week because he's down there getting some good Toltec Pyramid energy all up in his veins. He's there with Lee McCormick, Emily Greaves, and many other healers staying at the Dreaming House right at the base of the Toltec Pyramids. You can visit the Dreaming House, study the Toltec wisdom, and step out of the social matrix and into the spiritual matrix. Simply go to spiritrecovery.com, that is spiritrecovery.com, and click on the Journeys link. And when Bradley comes back, I'm going to interview him about his trip. I'm going to turn the tables and put him in that seat right over there, which you can't see right now, but I'm going to pull up Kyle because he's sitting in that seat.
And he'll be sitting here.
He will be sitting there. So yeah. Welcome back. I just read this. Since his, let's see, you were the slow clapper in Not Another Teen Movie. Look, just go to Wikipedia and read all about Kyle. Go to KyleCease.com. That's KyleCease.com. KyleCease.com. Yeah. He's got a great website, amazing videos. Kyle is rocking it. He is. He's really quite a force. I mean, you've got millions of YouTube views, you know, tens of thousands of subscribers. You got an amazing thing going on. And I want to pick up where we left off in the last segment talking about what were we talking about?
Well, when we went to commercial, we heard an ad, which that was Shadow Stevens, wasn't
yes,
it?
Yes, yeah, yes,
you know,
yes,
Shadow
yes.
Stevens.
That's
I've done
right,
his show.
Was. That's right. We were talking about we heard the commercial, which
yeah.
you pointed
and
out.
I said, how funny is this commercial that this is on? Because the commercial was about
yes.
you can go to seminars and you can hear this, and then they'll tell you another thing, or you can. And what I was going to say is this ad. Now, listen, there are things at seminars. I still go to seminars. I recommend them because if you can go to a seminar and say, look, not everything they say has to be in stone. Like if you go to an event and go, look, it's better than being in the living room. You know, I'd rather be at an event and
it's
and
community. There's other
around.
People.
Absolutely.
Right.
Trust me. I would take going
yeah.
to any seminar and being with positive people that are, because a lot of times too, the people in the audience are really much more in alignment with who I want to be with.
Totally.
And, you know,
right.
but here's the thing that I noticed too, is, I used to, and I still do. I'm probably going to the one coming up. I absolutely love Tony Robbins. I think he's unbelievable. But I remember spending about 2 years wanting to be Tony Robbins. You know, like you just watch him monster the stage, and you just if you're, it depends, I guess, where you're at. And you know, he's the best at getting people to be number one. But I just remember, as a comedian who's been on stage, going, I want to do that now. I want to have this size audience, and I understand everything he's teaching. And so for a while, I was a Tony Robbins. And, you know, when I went to and I still go to Agape, it's been a while because I've been on the road. But, you know, I go, man, I want to be like Michael Beckwith. So what really inspires me now, if it's anything outside of me, is also the people who just do the thing. Like who really – there's a video of a guy – I don't know if you've seen it – that's – he's an ex. He was a Vietnam vet, and he was walking. Did you see? He couldn't walk. He had his arms like in braces, right? And the video starts off. He doesn't say a word in this whole video, but it shows him. He's about 140 pounds overweight, so he's like, you know, 250 or something, and probably more than that. He's a big guy with crutches, and he's, and it says, I couldn't walk. Doctor said I couldn't do anything. And this video was released, I think his name's Arthur, and it was released April 30th, 2012. It's already got 6 million views, and it shows his before, and then it shows him attempting to do this really hardcore yoga, and he's falling over continually. And then it shows at the end, not only is he like completely fit, he's running, he's standing on his head. He's completely changed his life by doing, by being that. And there's, I think, our final excuse to not do it is teaching sometimes, because it's us saying to ourselves this stuff to motivate ourselves. And I do believe we need to teach ourselves and teach people. People still need this information and have their patterns broken. But you know how we can spot a person that says, I can't do this, and we understand their belief system is stopping them, right? Well, the last level before you actually do it is, I'm about to do it. When you say, I'm about to do it, that's the conscious person's, I can't do it. Do you get what I mean? When we declare 90-day things, and I do this all the time, I'm going to go 90 days before I'm in the moment. I'm going to go 90 days before I get really fit, and I'm going to, like we go, I'm going to start a diet tomorrow. So first I'm going to eat pizza. We actually start getting fatter because of our diet plan, and then the pizza's really good, so I go, one more day. Okay, April 1st, I start the diet. And then it's the reverse effect is happening. You know, you go to these events and you hear people inspiring you to do stuff. That's like buying P90X and watching people do it in front of you. You're not going to get fitter. You know, you're just going to picture yourself showing other people how to do P90X and not doing it.
I don't even I've heard of P90X.
It's a great workout
and,
system.
And we don't have to go into it here because I know you're not getting any kind of kickbacks.
I do it a lot, though.
Do you?
Yeah, it's great.
It's pretty brutal.
It is. It is. I do it, but I haven't lately, but I restarted. I'm doing a 90-day thing.
Well, you know what? There was another video that you wrote that about the best brain exercise ever.
Yes. That's cool you bring that up.
I would
this
love
is changing
to
my
talk
life.
About that. Yes.
So, okay. There's a one day I was on my way to an audition. This thing is getting so big. I have a book on the way about it that's
okay.
I'm telling you it's going to be number one. We have publishers already in, And I've just done a seminar about this, and it has actually truly transformed really everyone that went to it. Do you know how when you tell someone to get in the zone or get creative, and then they say or let go of something, and they always go, how?
Yeah.
Like how, right?
Yeah.
And we know that that's an ego. The ego wants to know how because so basically there's no – there's no way to physically see when you're in that inside the realm of ego. This is really deep talking right now. But when you're inside the realm of ego, you're trying to figure out how to create and you can't see outside that. That's why Einstein said you can't solve a problem at the same level of consciousness. So one day I was on my way to an audition. And at that point, I had had maybe 3 years of slumps. Like I went into the audition. I think part of the reason was because I didn't want to do what other people were telling me to do. You know, I like to audition my way and do my thing. That's why I like to be a comic and run the show. So I went to this audition and I had in my head basically anxiety about it because I'd only been screwing up auditions at that point. So it'd be like if you had a streak of bad dating or a streak of bad job interviews or whatever, and you start to link to your head that it's going to be bad. So I just out of nowhere had tried every technique I know and I couldn't get it. And then out of nowhere, I just decided to talk about this interview as if I already did it before I did it. I said, I'm going to talk about this interview as if I already did it. And what happened was, if when we hear all the time to visualize, what we really do is we visualize about 5% of the time, and then 95% of the time we're analyzing if it's working. Mm-hmm. So we're really practicing analyzing. Do you get what I mean by that?
And the visualizing is happening in the future. We're like seeing it happen. It hasn't happened yet. It's not happening now. It's like something that we're trying to bring in, and we're seeing it happen sometime in the future.
Right. So when you're seeing like The Secret and they say picture it, you're sitting there picturing I have a new car or whatever.
Right.
Then you're sitting here going, did it work?
And in that, or tomorrow, it's like, well, where's the car?
Right, right. But if you picture even in that visualization process, it's like an argument between your head and the visualizing. Mm-hmm. So if you visualize something as if it already happened, your mind stores it as fact, okay?
Right.
And if it stores it as fact, then what happens is the next thing your mind does is it goes, how did we get there? Mm-hmm. In other words, it doesn't doubt now. It's just wondering how we got there. So it could be anything. And what happens is you replace all your fear with creativity. So if we – what's today's date right now?
26th.
June 26th?
June 26th.
So what if we talked about June 26th like it was a month ago? And I said, do you remember a month ago when you and I were talking on that radio show? Mm-hmm. That was before I made the $1 million. Mm-hmm. You know, when I by totally getting into the zone. That was before I got really cut. By the way, right after that interview, I left and I went home and I worked on this other project that I was working on. I had this tour coming up. And then that night I did Bikram, even though I had done P90X that morning. And then the next day, this is the day after you interviewed me, I just remember spent a week juice fasting and just
And you should have heard what happened to me.
What happened to you, man?
Dude, I got this phone call from this national radio syndicated program, and they're like, "We love you, man. You're a little awkward, but you have a little flavor." They were like, "You're perfect for the show that we're putting together."
Right.
I was like, "Wow, I totally didn't expect that."
Wow. And so,
amazing.
How did you get that? What did you do that made them want that?
You know, I just showed up and I was myself and I just had conversation and I just was present and I just was me.
Yeah.
Really.
So here's where it's really big is that for me, a lot of times if I picture something external that happened to me, like what you just said, what I have to do is get myself in alignment with that. Meaning if I say, like I said as a joke, I said I made $1 million because I wanted to show an example. My mind, like Google, like if you say, how did I make $1 million? It will come up with how you did it. How did this happen? So, you know, we know that the questions we ask will get the answer. So if you say, why me? You'll get because you suck because you always do this. So if I say, I made $1 million, my mind immediately goes, well, how did you? Uh-huh. And it starts to answer it. It goes by literally getting in front of a camera 10 hours a day, creating video after video. You have a third Comedy Central CD coming out September 4th. You started making video after video, promoting it. But then you came up with a thing where you came up – see, this is already doing it.
Yeah.
Then you came up with a seminar in October where if people – bought 25 of your CDs and got their Christmas shopping done early.
Yeah.
So see, immediately I just came up with a thing. If you buy my CD on September 4th, if you buy 25 of them, I'll give you a free ticket to my 3-day seminar.
Mm-hmm.
So see how right away I came up with an idea, but that was within 20 seconds, right? So if you live in the outcome and you do this exercise, let's say you're in a fight with your girlfriend.
Mm-hmm.
You're just like, I remember when we were so amazing.
Mm-hmm.
You don't say anything like how we got over it.
Mm-hmm.
Do you get what I'm saying? Because that's the negative.
Mm-hmm.
You say how you became incredible. If you're broke, you don't say you start to say, I remember how I became really successful, really rich. Like immediately your mind starts going, I watched this How to Make Money video. I watched these other people's videos. And then I started taking action, you know, and I came up with all these different creative ways. Immediately, just by doing that minute exercise with you just now, I just came up with an idea that I'm going to implement.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I'm going to Seattle.
You're welcome.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
I'm going to Seattle to do 10 days of this exercise into the camera. And I believe that actually I don't care about making money at all. That's not a thing to me. Like, I'm for it, but I'm not.
Mm-hmm.
But I still needed something to measure it by. But my belief is I'm going to do this thing in camera in 10 days, and I'm going to make $1 million in 10 days.
Okay.
Because if I'm doing this exercise, I'm going to have one camera that I'm doing the Kollegial exercise. It's called Kollegial because it's my name and my buddy Diego's combined. And I'm going to do this exercise And I'm going to have another camera where every time I have an idea for a video, I will implement the video. And so I'll be like, and then I made a video where you have a contest, right? So then I'll look into this camera and go, hi, my name's Kyle Cease. I have a CD coming out. So there's no time for anticipation or anxiety or fear. Mm-hmm. You're in the state right there. You shoot it in that state and it's done, right? Yeah, so let's say I had an idea and I want to bring Tony Robbins into it. I go, blah, blah, blah. And then I brought Tony Robbins. Hey, Tony, it's Kyle, blah, blah, blah. We shoot it. Then my brother uploads it and we send it to Tony Robbins. Uh-huh. You get what I'm saying?
Absolutely.
So like this exercise gets you into the it's done state and you can stay there. And even when you hit a wall, you can say, I remember when I got even freer on the other side of that wall. And you can do this forever and you constantly are ascending.
Well, we're going to go to a commercial again here, but how can people find that video?
So that video is on my YouTube. It's youtube.com/Kyle Cease and it's called The Greatest Brain Exercise Ever. The Greatest Brain Exercise Ever. Right. And you know what? There are probably 40 videos up there. One's called Wake Up. One's called You. Just Y-O-U. These are videos that I have where it's me just riffing into the camera talking about how unlimited we are in all kinds of different ways.
Yeah, and they're amazing. I mean, you can see just in this program, Kyle just it's just coming through, flying through. So we're gonna come, we're gonna go to commercial.
Excellent.
Come right back. This will be our final segment. And man, I would do this for hours.
I could just keep going, man.
I just could keep going.
Because so, it gets, this is what I'm talking about. It gets better and better, right?
It just gets deeper and better and juicier and grittier and funner and I mean just everything. It just.
And that's why we can't make an interview or a stage performance or anything more important than every moment, because this is how I live my life. You know what I mean? And so if I'm in a studio or in a stage or peeing or whatever I'm doing, it's the same.
Awesome.
You know what I'm saying?
We'll be right back with Kyle Cease. Thank you for joining us, everybody. Thank you, Kyle.
Thanks.
Stay put. You are in the right place. Cool Change Radio would like to welcome all their new talk shows, including Saving Lives with Susan Blonner, Dates and Mates with Dear Mrs. D. Damona Hoffman, Love, Serve, Feed People, and Remember God with Michael Brian Baker. And look for other upcoming shows on Cool Change Radio. We'll be right back with more of Kyle Cease. My name is Brian Reeves. My website is managingthemagic.com. You're listening to Cool Change Radio, your home for self-improvement, your solutions radio network.
Get quality goods for less from Bag City, serving all of Reno, Denver, Las Vegas, Bakersfield, Salt Lake City, Los Angeles, and many more cities. Up to 70% below retail on everything. Coin purses, wallets, organizers, purses, briefcases, backpacks, traveling garment bags, and ladies and men's leather jackets. All discounted, all up to 70% below retail. Bag City, the best for less. Bag City serving all of Reno, Denver, Las Vegas, Bakersfield, Salt Lake City, Los Angeles, and many more cities. Contact Bag City at 818-990-1795. That's Bag City, quality goods for less money. Bag City, where 15% of all sales go to local charities. You can't beat that. You help local charities while getting quality goods at up to 70% below retail. Contact Bag City now at 818-990-1795. Contact Bag City today and get quality goods for less money. That's 818-990-1795. Shop Bag City to save. Shop Bag City for charity. Bag City, 818-990-1795.
You're listening to The Quick Fix with Bradley Quick. Purpose, power, motivation. We'll be right back.
Today, experience The Quick Fix, a simple process for positive change. Written by Bradley Quick, author, producer, motivational speaker, and host of the award-winning radio talk show, The Quick Fix with Bradley Quick on CoolChangeRadio.com. Bradley's passion for life is evident in his book, written so you can experience health, find your purpose, and have more effective relationships. Beating insurmountable odds, overcoming death, and being paralyzed, Bradley fought his way back so he could help you conquer your struggles. Experience increased health, vitality, passion, and purpose in your life right now with The Quick Fix, and read about Bradley's courage, ambition, and determination to live. Whether the issue is your thoughts, your physical body, or you just want to feel better and be happy, The Quick Fix, a simple process for positive change, will change your life. For only $19.95 plus shipping and handling, take positive action now and receive a free guided meditation CD with your order. That's a $20 value free with your order today. Go to BradleyQuick.com. That's BradleyQuick.com. Take control and begin feeling better now. Get the book and free CD now at BradleyQuick.com.
Welcome back. This segment is brought to you by Wow. Thanks to all of you joining us on CoolChangeRadio.com, Facebook, and BradleyQuick.com. As you know, you can catch our live and video recorded shows at CoolChangeRadio.com with over 700 hours of Bradley's best audio interviews. You're listening to Cool Change Radio, broadcasting live from Freddie Siegel Studios, your home for self-improvement and a place for positive life enhancement. We are being supported in large part by one of Bradley's favorite charities, the Cool Change Foundation. The foundation was created to help families and all the children in those families. They do that by providing positive transformational life enhancement methods and techniques to those children's caretakers, which is usually the moms and dads, so that they can overcome negative habits and become better role models and providers for the kids. And as a direct result, the children's home and family life becomes more nurturing and loving. You can help the Cool Change Foundation, help the moms and dads and kids in your community, and you can do it right now by sending your donation of love and support directly to the foundation. The website is thecoolchangefoundation.org. That's thecoolchangefoundation.org. Simply click Support Us at the top. And no donation is too small, and I know that to be true. I work with a lot of artists and charities, and it's true. No donation is too small. Every little bit helps. So please go to thecoolchangefoundation.org, and all the folks here at Cool Change Radio, thank you. So I'm back with Kyle Cease, comedian, inspirational speaker extraordinaire, and one dimpled man, apparently.
Yeah.
That's You wanted to – we were just talking over the break about the difference between letting go
and achieving.
Yeah. What do you mean by that?
Well, I you know, as I said, I've been doing comedy forever, and then I started to learn, you know, a friend of mine named Shore Slocum talks about this, but this is so important. This is the whole essence of everything that I'm kind of talking about, is that he talks about that there's basically four levels. I mean, there's a ton of levels, obviously, and however we want to define it.
Well, Paul McCartney said that there are seven levels when he was high.
Oh, really?
One day when he that was the secret of life.
And Super Mario Brothers says there's eight, four.
And then
level eight.
It goes up to eight.
Yeah,
so there's a, the point is four. That there's just there's
right.
Right. Yeah.
So the first one that most people are in is this place called he says it's called To Me, where basically people think that life is running them. You know, where you go, it's because of my mom, it's because of you're living in blame. You go, it's because of my past or my ex or whatever. And eventually, if your life is based on what's going on outside of you, you're going to always stress, right? Mm. Eventually, that's going to drive you into the ground, and you're going to do one of three things. You're going to either get addicted to something, you're going to become suicidal, or you're going to figure out what caused it. Now, 90% of the world is in that victim mentality, and when you go down, the only question you have, if you're going to try to fix it, is how do I fix that problem? Mm. So when you lose – so this is another reason why a lot of the speakers have a hard time connecting with America, because they're at a low, and they think that their actual problem is they need to get that girl back. Do you get what I'm saying?
Oh, of course, yeah.
They don't know that we're at a place where – or I feel like I'm an understanding that if I'm stressed at all, it's because of my own resistance to what is at all, no matter what. Like if I lose a person in my life, that's – any time I'm stressed, it's me saying I'm deciding it shouldn't have been that way. Mm-hmm. It's almost selfish, you know? Mm-hmm. And so
right. –
And so when you hit that wall, you only can go to that achiever level, and that's the reason why Tony Robbins and Shore Slocum are so fantastic. The Secret are so fantastic, mm-hmm. because the way you talk to people is, do you want to make $1 million? Do you want a car? Do you know what I'm saying? That's the way that they're listening. So that's how that second level is. You go to this place where you go, I can make anything happen. Mm-hmm. You start to understand if you change your thinking to what you do want, you can have $1 million, you can have all the money, you can have the life, you can get the girl. But the problem is, in that level, you're achieving, so you're living in the future. You're constantly in a place of, when something happens, I'll be happy.
Still like carrot on a stick.
Yeah.
Kind of.
And the truth is, if those things make you happy, they'll also make you depressed if you lose them. And if that
or never get them. You'll just be caught that eternal angst of not having it.
Right. And so you're constantly in this place of achieving to make things happen. So eventually what happens is you finally start to go crazy and you lose control. The third level is called through me, which is a no control state, basically. And through me, you're going effortlessly, right? You have direction, like a road trip. Mm-hmm. Do you get what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Like a road trip, we go, we're going to go to New York. You don't spend 99% of the time going, aren't we in New York yet? Aren't we there yet? Right? So that's what the level two has. There's a lot of, we're going to make it happen. And the problem also in that level two thing is you're sitting here going, my way that I know from the start of this is how it's going to be. And you ignore all these amazing opportunities that are everywhere.
And you said something in one of your videos that I love. You also said, you also don't just say, well, we're just going to not be in Los Angeles for a while.
Oh, yeah. I'm trying to think of what the context was that I was saying that in. But
I think it was the video about how to make money.
Right.
It was like the second half, the second 15 minutes. It was a context of, again, how to achieve something, how to get somewhere.
Right.
Maybe I'm throwing it up on you. But
no, but I know what you're saying. You know,
And the point, and also the point I want to make is here for everyone watching, like Kyle has amazing videos where he, all the stuff that we're talking about here on the show, he really dives into, you know, with these beautifully coherent, insightful thoughts. And so I just encourage everyone to watch that. So, but
fast paced too. If you're like, oh, get to the point, they're
oh my God, the points are flying one after the other. That it's just like even on this show. I mean, you know, we could do this for a long time.
Yeah,
I just know we could keep going.
And you know what's funny is if we did do it a long time, hour 7 and 8 would be so good. You know what I mean? Because we'd have to be at the point and we'd be so tight by then.
Yeah.
And that's what I'm talking about is letting go gets you into this place of flow. And then eventually what's happening here is we're losing the monitor. The part of us – we're losing the part of our brain that comes in the consumer world. In other words, if you check your Facebook 30 times, right, and then you're going, why is that girl talking to that guy and why is this da-da-da, and you're putting yourself in lack. Well, then when you start to create, that same lack comes in as a monitor going, how's the writing going? And so you start to write a joke as a comedian or a singer, whatever. You write a song. Immediately as you're writing it, you're monitoring it, right? So you go under this illusion that like what this is right here has to be the final product. And you write for 1 minute and you go, oh, screw it. That's not going to work. So you write that way. Let's say you write like 10 minutes and nothing comes out. Then what happens is you look at the last 10 minutes and you go under this huge illusion that the next 10 minutes will be like the last 10 minutes. But the truth is you're going through a process of undoing the monitor. And more and more and more you start to become what my analogy is we're like alarm clocks. An alarm clock doesn't try to get another alarm clock to like it. It doesn't even try to create. Its only job is to stick its antenna up and play the music that's already playing right now. So all I'm doing is just showing up and telling you what I'm thinking. And it's that effortless. Even saying how do I start creating is still too much work. It's just right now, even start is too much work. You've started, just be there and go there. So but this last year I've discovered that as I let go of things, I achieve effortlessly, like so fast. About a year and a half ago, I was doing this thing where I was with the famous comedian Louis Anderson. We were teaching comedians how to become successful comics. And what happened was a dark comic, didn't know who I was, and he wrote a blog about me that basically pitched me as a scam artist. He didn't know that we weren't even making money. The money was just going to websites. And
when you say comic, you mean somebody
like it was a comic who now we're friends, ironically, but he's a dark. Dark meaning like he's kind of got that George Carlin thing, but it's very dark, like drugs and the darkness and everything. And but you know what? That's also his authenticity because he's a great comic too, you know. But it was weird though because he wrote this blog about me. He didn't know who I was. He didn't know anything about the thing we were doing. And what he wrote was, you know, basically saying this positivity is not real and everything and was very angry. And the blog was written and then under it on Facebook, the comics were passing it around left and right by the thousands. Now, right before that happened, I was with Louis and I said to him, I want to get over what people think about me. And he goes, well, I wonder what that is. So I was about to have a car take me to the airport and I go to the hotel room and I check my email and I see this blog because everyone's throwing it at me with a lot of angry words towards me. And I read the blog and I'm pretty much paralyzed. So I tell the car, this is crazy. I tell the car to leave without me. And I sit in the hotel and I go, I'm about to learn something. I don't know what it is. And I just stayed through the pain because I knew not to go get drunk because I'd get addicted to alcohol. I knew not to. So on day four, I had this moment where the buildup was so extreme that I had this moment where I was like, I can't do anything about what these people think about me. So I release it. Like, I don't have a choice. It's mm-hmm. either I strain trying to control what mm-hmm. thousands of people are saying right mm-hmm. now, mm-hmm. or I release it. And I felt really good suddenly, and I flew back home, and I tried to get my DVD player to play, and it wouldn't play a movie, and then it wouldn't play another one. And finally, the movie Adaptation played. And there's a scene where Nicolas Cage says to his girlfriend, or says to his brother, he goes, in high school, there's a girl you liked, and she was talking bad about you, and you didn't care. And he said, why is that? And the brother said, because whatever she says about me, she can't take away from me how much I love her. Mm-hmm. And then he goes, you are what you love, and not what loves you. Mm-hmm. Up until that moment, anytime mm-hmm. we're stressing, mm-hmm. I realized I had been what loves me, meaning what's the audience think of me when I go mm-hmm. on stage? What's this crowd? If you're nervous at all, you're mm-hmm. thinking, what's, you know, the audience think? What's the guy you're taking over for think? What, mm-hmm. you know? You are what you love. When you're a kid, you go back to creating. You were in your house, in your bedroom, pretending you were a DJ, right? Right. You're going, it's 7:09, and I was doing yeah. comedy as a little kid in the bedroom and then on stage, and I didn't care what people thought. You weren't ever fantasizing about managing a list of people. Right. You weren't So I realized I got to go back to that place of loving people like the sun doesn't care what people – the sun – like Wayne right. Dyer said, the sun never says you owe me. Right. And if you go to that place, you are completely free. So I started identifying everything that was resistance and going, that's being what loves me. And if you go to this place of I am what I love and I'm just putting this out, what happens is you have this crazy, effortless, constant ideas flowing. You have no fear anymore. And so I went 90 days of going, I'm going to only eat raw food and not eat anything cooked. And then I started losing my addictions to everything. And I remember thinking, wow, I'm aligning with my purpose bigger than even being in comedy clubs anymore. So I looked into the camera and I said, we were doing a documentary. I said, I'm done taking comedy clubs on the road. And then three auditions showed up in my phone in that minute. Mm. I have it on tape. Mm. Then I let go of dating for a while. Mm-hmm. I said, I'm not going to date for a while. You and I met around this right. time. Yeah. On day 90, I walked into Whole Foods.
So there was no hope for me.
Right. Well, I said, yeah, you can't. But on day 90, I walked into Whole Foods on day 90 and yeah. found this girl and said, that's my wife. You know, mm. and then for 6 months she was taken. So for 6 months I kept going into Whole Foods, but I released the idea that I could have her. Yeah. Okay. Mm. Then you remember July 3rd when you came and saw me at Flappers?
Absolutely.
Yeah. In between shows, yeah. she told me she was single. Mm-hmm. That second show was the standing O because I was crushing it for her. 2 weeks later we were engaged. Wow. Now, in this process, I have discovered that anytime I have anything that I'm holding on to, you have to let go of it, because if you're analyzing if you should let go of something you know you shouldn't be with, meaning you're in a bad relationship, you're in a job you don't like, whatever, that's an argument between your unlimited potential and your fear. So your unlimited potential is like, we can do what Gandhi did. Your fear is like, well, if I break up with this person, we can't go to Cheesecake Factory every Thursday. Your unlimited potential is like, it doesn't matter, because if you do what we do, we can own every Cheesecake Factory. And you're you know, like, yeah, but a paid vacation I won't have, you know, and... So I started getting that as I let go of stuff, I let go of one of the biggest agencies in the world because they didn't align with what I was feeling. They were one of the biggest agencies. The next week I did Gate, but my confidence was through the roof because I didn't have anything that I was analyzing the whole time.
Yeah, yeah. Kyle was one of the MCs with Louis Anderson and Suzanne Wong at Gate, the Global Alliance for Transformational Entertainment, which featured Jim Carrey, Eckhart Tolle, Marianne Williamson, Domingo Ruiz, all these just amazing, amazing. It was an extraordinary event.
Did you see the night show, though, that I had with Eckhart and Jim when I came on and did like 8 minutes?
You know, man, I didn't, because I was so busy working the event.
It was insane.
But we have it on tape, so I will see it eventually.
I'm dying to see it.
Yeah, we'll see it. We'll probably put that out soon, hopefully on YouTube.
But when I had that agency, I was analyzing all the time if I should drop them. Mm. And then I realized I was practicing analyzing. I was analyzing. I didn't know where we should go to dinner. I didn't know anything because I was analyzing. When I let go of that agency, mm-hmm. I lost the analyzing guy mm-hmm. about everything. Mm. And I did the whole set mm-hmm. with Jim Carrey and mm-hmm. Eckhart Tolle mm-hmm. off the cuff. Mm. And it happens because you let go of the thing. If you're holding on to something, you don't realize that what you're losing mm-hmm. by holding on to it. Mm-hmm. You can always measure when you let go of something. You can always measure what you'll lose. You can never see what you'll gain. And like an obese person goes, if I want to get fit, I can see if I won't be able to eat Krispy Kremes anymore. Mm-hmm. But they don't see that they might be able to meet their great-grandkids, right, that they'll save millions on hospital bills, that they'll show other people they could do it, that they might be on Oprah. You know what I mean?
Kyle, we got to wrap it up, man.
Yeah, I'm going long. I'm sorry.
But this, I want to give you a chance just to share with everyone what you've got coming up. You know, everything that we've been talking about, again, is available at kylecease.com, youtube.com/kylecease. He's obviously just, you know, I'm just really humbled, man, sitting here with you, and this has been such a gift.
Thank you.
Really, thank you.
Thanks for listening.
What's happening for you? What's coming next?
So September 4th, I have a Comedy Central CD-DVD combo coming out. It's my third one, and this is the first product I have coming out with them that I'm crazy excited about.
Okay.
And then I think I'm going to do another event that's like this, that's like what we're talking about with that Kegel exercise. Mm-hmm. We just did one in May, and people's lives really did change because they led their own thing. They sat there and did that exercise, understood what they wanted, and they understood that they had their own breakthrough after breakthrough, and we're like 50, 60 days later after that event that I had, and everyone's writing me that they're all, like, I saw some of them, they're all healthy now and they're richer because they suddenly figured out how much power they have. And it's not about achieving. It's about letting go. Mm-hmm. And it's about trusting. And it's so easy to have everything you want. You just have to allow it.
Yeah.
Just allow it to come in.
Well, I'm just as a human being on this planet, I'm really grateful that you're here, that you're bringing that levity and the comedy to what, you know, again, to this planet, not even to one realm or one this, because a lot of people are paying attention to you. People that don't even have any idea who Eckhart Tolle is, you know, because you're entertaining, you're funny, you know, you connect with people where they're at. You know, that's what people are hungry for. They want to be connected with, and there's that. But we want to be uplifted in ways that aren't manipulative or cheesy or
right.
And so I really value what you're doing, man.
Thank you. So grateful
that you're here, that we're sharing the planet together, and
thank you, man. I appreciate it. This has been a fun time, and you allowing me to come on the show allows me to express myself and feel better internally. You know, as I do, I know there's external results too, and hopefully people watching got something out of it. Feel free to, people can write me, by the way, at kylecease@yahoo. Or actually, it will get really responded to quickly if you write kylecease@gmail. kylecease@gmail.com.
Excellent.
And we'll respond.
Tomorrow, my guests are three midgets who are Oprah.
Oh, really?
Coincidentally enough.
Really?
Yeah.
That's weird. That's kind of weird because I had said munchkin, so you have that.
I do.
Yeah. So they're kind of close.
I do.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're going to explain the difference to
me
because I don't quite get it. I've probably just offended a whole subgroup of folks. But that's part of, it's not intentional.
Right. You didn't.
I really didn't.
I think we so have been trained to be scared of saying anything. We have truth, man. We're just being funny and we're just being fun. You're doing your thing. It's great.
Thank you, man. This has been a real pleasure. This is just my third guest hosted show. So
you did good, man. You did really good.
Thank you.
Yeah.
I appreciate that. I feel good. And you've been a great guest.
Thank you.
I just sit here and let you talk.
I'll stop. But you're good. I'm proud of you.
Thank you.
I'll be over here.
So that was Kyle Cease, everybody. And again, his website is kylecease.com. At this point, I'm just gonna hand it over to you. I've let this run a little bit long because I think that there was just some really beautiful stuff going on here. There's just a beautiful flow going, and I feel like I just had an opportunity to share, you know, a planetary treasure with everybody that's watching. So catch Kyle Cease. He's got it going on. He's funny. I'm just going to stop, you know, kissing on all over you here.
Anyway,
Kyle Cease, my name is Brian Reeves. I'm with ManagingTheMagic.com. That's my website, ManagingTheMagic.com. I'm filling in for Bradley Quick on The Quick Fix, and tomorrow my guest is Parashakti, who's going to talk to us about the dance of liberation and the healing journey that she's created through her own life and through dance and through movement of the body. So I'm looking forward to that. Thank you all for joining us today. Taylor, it's all yours, brother. Thank you.